Hello friends, welcome to my channel Dev's Institute. Today we will see one more topic from processor architecture and interfacing, that is 8255 programmable peripheral interface, it is PPI. Before I start, I request you to subscribe to my channel and click on bell icon to get instant notification about the new videos. It's absolutely free of cost. 8255 is a programmable peripheral interface. As the name suggests, it is the interface to attach peripheral devices to the processor. So, processor can interface with the peripheral devices through 8255. It contains three 8-bit I/O ports named as port A, port B, port C. It consists of total 24 I/O pins, so 3 ports with 8 I/O, 3 ports with 8 bit, so 3 8s are 24 I/O pins, and the pin IC 8255 IC contains total 40 pins. This is detailed architecture of 8255. First block is data bus buffer. Data bus buffer is a bus data bus D0 to D7 which is used to connect to processor. So on this side you have processor, on this side you have peripheral device, and this is the interface between processor and the peripheral device. So data bus buffer has input from D0 to D7 data bus. D0 to D7 data bus is a bidirectional data bus, means processor can read from this data bus or write through the processor through this data bus, and this is the buffer. So data read from this pin will be stored here. This data bus buffer is internally connected to internal data bus of 8255, and through that internal data bus this data can be transferred to port A, port B, port C or group controls. Then next we have read write control logic. So read write control logic is basically helpful in controlling read write operation and as well as the port selection operation. So we'll see what are the inputs to read write control logic. First input is CS bar pin, it is active low pin. So CS stands for chip select. So when 0 is sent on this pin, that means 8255 and processor communication is enabled. If this pin is high, means if 1 is sent on this pin, then processor and 8255 communication is not enabled. So this pin should be low in order to 8255 in order to enable 8255. Then we have read bar pin, write bar pin. 0 on this pin indicates that 8255 will perform reading operation, and 0 on this pin will indicate that it will perform write operation. So either this pin will be 0 or this pin will be 0. So it will be either a read operation or write operation. Then you have reset pin. Reset pin will reset the control word register of 8255, and also it will reset all ports to the input mode. So by default all ports are set to input mode. Now in addition to this, you have two pins called as A0 and A1. This A0 and A1 pins are used to select the ports from port A, port B and port C. We'll see how this is done. Consider that your chip select signal is 0. It has to be 0 to enable 8255. So this is 0 and A1, A0 are 0, 0. So port A will be selected. Chip select is 0 and A1, A0 are 0, 1. Then port B will be selected. Chip select is 0, A1, A0 are 1, 0. Port C will be selected. And chip select is 0, A1, A0 are 1, 1. Then control register will be selected. But if chip select is 1, chip select bar is 1, then whatever may be the values of A1 and A0, no selection will be done as 8255 is not enabled in this case. So these A0 and A1 pins will help us to select the port. So A0 and A pin will select the port. Read bar, write bar operation will select whether it is read operation or write operation. Then you have port A. Port A belongs to group A. Port A has 8 input output lines PA0 to PA7 and this block represents the buffer of port A. So PA data read from PA0 to PA7 will be stored in buffer of port A and data to be written to port pins will be stored in this buffer. Then you have port B. Port B, same as that of port A, it has also 8 IO pins and this is buffer for the port B. Then you have port C. Port C is divided into two parts, port C upper and port C lower. Port C lower accepts input from PC0 to PC3 or writes data to PC0 to PC3 and this is 4-bit buffer. Similarly, port C upper will be responsible for data received on PC4 to PC7 pins or it is responsible for data to be written to PC4 to PC7 in case of output operation and this is also 4-bit buffer. This is group A control. So group A control will control the port A and port C upper. Now you can see here for group A control, group A control has input from read write control logic as well as from internal data bus. So data accepted from the processor can be transferred to group A control through internal data bus and data from read write control logic also will be sent to group A control and by this way group A control will try to manage the group A, that is port A and port C upper. Similarly, here it is group B control. Group B control also has input from read write control logic and has data bus buffer input through internal data bus and group B control will control port C lower and group port B. So port C lower and port B will form the group B. Also read write control logic output is connected to all ports, port A, port B, port C upper and port C lower. So this is all about the 8255 architecture. Now we will see its pin description. Now we already have discussed all pins of 8255. Just we'll go rapidly through this pin description. It is a 40 pin IC. It contains VCC and ground VCC and ground pins for VCC and ground connection. Then we have D0 to D7 pins. These pins are bidirectional data pins which are used to connect the 8255 to the processor to read or write data to or from the processor. Then you have port A pins PA0 to PA7. So these pins are again bidirectional pins, input output pins which are connected to port A buffer. Then we have PB0 to PB7 pins which are port B pins. Port B pins again 8 IO pins bidirectional and they are connected to port B data buffer. Then we have PC0 to PC3 which are connected to port C lower and PC4 to PC7 which are connected to port C upper data buffer. Then we have read bar, chip select bar, write bar, reset pins which are connected to read write control logic and we also have A0 to A7 which are responsible for selecting the specific ports, port A, port B from the three different IO ports. So this is all about the pin diagram of 8255 PPI, that is programmable peripheral interface. Thank you very much for watching my video. If you like my video, please press like button given below the video. If you have any queries, you can ask me through comment section. Thank you.